jobs, another big advantage of being in Hong Kong is availability of jobs, internships, visas, for example. So how does that work?
Jobs in Hong Kong pay a lot. I actually know one person who's paying for his own tuition fees as well as living expenses completely because he has such a good well-paying job.
Part-time job.
Yeah. So most common job among students is becoming a tutor for other IB students.
Okay.
And they get paid really well, and that covers most of the living expenses.
Amazing.
So in Hong Kong, the main language requirement for jobs is English. And usually they prefer somebody who can also speak Chinese. I know lots of my friends who do not know Chinese at all, but they still have jobs in Hong Kong. And it's very easy to get a work visa once you've studied there. And even the job placements are very good. Most of my international friends who were working in Hong Kong actually got their job offers like 3-4 months before graduation. They had the job offers in hand. So I would say the job security is pretty good in Hong Kong, apart from the fact that we also have really good salaries there.
So from what I can see, intense research culture, great job opportunities, internship opportunities, visa being available, cost being low. So the way I see it is it's a great place for someone to be.
Yeah, that's true.
Super. So looking at an Asian school, if you were to share how the Asian schools are slightly different from the American or the British schools, what would you like to say?
Well, one main thing is that Asian universities are very focused on academics.
Right.
And it's really difficult to get a good grade. You actually have to work hard to get above a 3.0.
Oh my God.
Because usually people think like, oh, 3.0, I don't have to study to get that. In USD, yes, you do have to study to get even above 3.0.
Seriously.
Because it's so competitive.
Yeah.
Like we have a curve system like American universities, but that curve is so steep that even you could get a 90% and still get a C.
Oh my God.
So it's not like the IB system. In the IB system, everyone does well, everyone gets good grade.
Individually, right?
Over here, if everyone does well and you do less well,
it's relative.
You're bad. And most other Chinese students just spend their time studying because for them, university is about studying.
Right.
They don't, and if they'll do any other activities, they'll focus on just one activity. So they're very focused people, so they don't have a fraternity culture.
Right.
They have societies and houses, and they are very serious about them. But they're only the local and Chinese students who take part in it.
Right.
Even if international students want to take part, we aren't welcome there.
Let's talk about the discussions in class and sometimes outside class. How free-flowing is that?
Well, it completely depends from course to course. So my friends who are in the business school say there's a lot of discussion-based, but in engineering school, it's very limited because the engineering school is less international professors, there are more local Chinese professors, and in their culture, there is a culture of subordination. So it's always like the teachers at the top, the students at the bottom, and the teachers always write the student cannot say that
challenge,
you tell the teacher
right.
that he or she is wrong. So because of that, many students don't have a habit of speaking in class.
Okay.
And another thing is that in the culture, it's like if you always tell the right answer in class, you're a show-off.
Oh. I understand the language of instruction at HKUST is English, but given 80% Cantonese and 10% Mandarin and all of that student body, is language an issue?
To a certain extent. Most activities are conducted in Cantonese, so you have your meetings of different societies as well as your movie nights or going trekking, and most people just prefer talking to each other in Cantonese.
Right.
So although they've studied English, English is always a second or a third language for them, so that they find it very difficult to interact with us international students, and due to which they prefer sticking amongst themselves.
Oh, okay.
And sometimes even if they can speak English, they don't have the confidence to speak
right.
it. Because in their culture, it's like whenever they make a mistake, people laugh at them. They're scared that if they speak English with me, I'll start laughing at them. And in order to merge with them better, I started to learn Cantonese in second semester. And as soon as you do that, it makes a big difference because they feel like, wow, an international student is making an effort to speak with us and learn our language.
Yeah.
Although it's not a compulsory course, I was doing it for fun. And also with sports, it's mostly locals. Most of the Indian students actually don't take part in a lot of sports.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah, again, very focused on just having fun, like partying or studying. I'm one of the few people who's very serious about his sporting and extracurriculars there. And even mainland Chinese students, the same problem. They've always studied in Mandarin. And so most of them learn English just before coming to UST so that they can get into the university.
Okay.
So the food on campus is mostly local Chinese food. And it's not like the Chinese food in India. It's very different. It's not spicy at all. And the only time they have spicy will be a little bit of pepper. But I'm a big foodie.
No.
So in 1 month, I got really bored of it. And I was like, most of the places around Hong Kong are very expensive. So I decided to go around on foot, just exploring the lanes of Hong Kong and going to random street stalls. And although I didn't know Chinese, I would just have to show them a photo of what I wanted. And sometimes I don't even know what I'm eating. So people ask me, like, what is the best dish you've eaten in Hong Kong? I said, I don't even know the names.
I have a picture on my phone.
I have a photo of it. And so after that, I realized I was really passionate about food. So I went online, started researching about different restaurants, like the best restaurants under 50 or 100 Hong Kong dollars there. And then I started enjoying it because Hong Kong is a really diverse place when it comes to food. Just like Mumbai, you have insane variety of cuisines. So that's why this year I got an induction cooker and I started cooking my own food. So
amazing.
I started cooking using YouTube videos. I taught myself how to cook eggs and pasta, and I never done this in Bombay. So for me, it was a new experience. And so like whatever money I saved on cooking, I used to go outside and spend it on better food. And it actually helped me lose weight because I was actually knew what exactly I'm putting in my food while cooking it. So I lost 4 kgs this semester.
Well, that explains your director of the cuisine society position.
Yeah, because I realized I'm really passionate about my food. So I'm like, maybe I should definitely join the cuisine society and initiate more activities and go to more restaurants with people who are also really passionate about food like me. So to be honest, the Chinese style of partying is very different from our idea of partying. They don't like drinking and dancing. So they prefer just playing games at parties and eating different kinds of foods. So most international students prefer going out for parties. So in Hong Kong, the two main clubbing areas are Wan Chai and Lam Kwai Fong. So when you go to these places, you won't feel like in Hong Kong anymore because at least 90% of the crowd is non-Chinese.
Okay.
And it's not that expensive either. So most people just go out to party a lot. So I hike a lot in Hong Kong. I've gone for 14 hikes in my 15 months
wow.
in Hong Kong. And this is something people don't know about Hong Kong.
Yeah.
So when I went to Hong Kong, I had no idea that you can hike in Hong Kong in the middle of the city. In 5 minutes, you go from the station and you're suddenly in the middle of a mountain.
Oh.
And it's pretty convenient because you have your buses and trains going to the beginning of most of hiking trails. And you have maps and websites devoted just for hikers. So it's amazing fun hiking. And my craziest experience was last year in June when I went hiking with one of my friends. This was the first time we went hiking without a group. And we decided not to go to the main route. We decided to make our own route. And we got lost.
Oh.
So we couldn't we were trying to use Google Maps, but we couldn't find ourselves even on Google Maps. And it was pretty crazy because it was around sunset, it was getting pretty dark.
Yeah.
And it was like we were at the edge of a cliff. The slopes were really steep. We had no equipment on us. And we were really scared, but we weren't ready to give up yet. We managed to reach the top of the peak and find easier route to come down the other side. And although it was really scary, it was one of the best experiences I've ever had in my life.
Kianch, could you describe your school in one word?
Well, I think it would be crazy because it's crazily academic, but it's also crazily diverse.
So thank you so much for being on the show. You really opened that little window to Hong Kong for us.
Yeah, I hope I can convince more people to come to HQSD.
I'm sure looking at all the pluses that you've listed here, you would certainly have motivated some students. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Please click the subscribe button below. Like me at facebook.com/chetchat101. Follow my Twitter handle, chetchat101, or at Instagram, chetchat101. Please leave your comments in the sections below. And if you'd like me to feature any particular college, please let me know. Thank you.